Welcome to another very informative video on variable frequency drive. In this video, we will learn why do we need VFD, how do VFD works, and what are the components of VFD. In VFD, V stands for variable, F stands for frequency, and D stands for drive. The speed of motor, especially induction motors, can be changed by two methods. First method is by controlling voltage. The disadvantage of this method is that it results in large flux density, which disturbs flux distribution in motor, and torque applied to the load is also affected. The most efficient method of changing speed is by controlling supply frequency, as supply frequency is directly proportional to motor speed in RPM. The flux density also remains constant. But wait, only changing the frequency of motor to control its speed will not apply on all loads. Here, we have examples of constant torque loads. Compressors and conveyor belts are examples of constant torque loads. It means that the torque requirement of such type of loads is constant on all speeds. Let's see how induction motor can produce constant torque on different speeds. For this, we have to refer to torque speed characteristics of motor. Here, we can see constant torque can be generated at different speeds by keeping V over F ratio constant. In other words, in order to increase the speed, we have to increase the frequency and supply voltage at the same time to keep V by F ratio constant. And this is the main function of variable frequency drive. Now let's see the components and working of VFD. VFD comprises of three stages. First is the rectifier stage. Second is the DC bus stage. And third is the inverter stage. Let's discuss all stages briefly. The first stage is rectifier stage, which is made up of six diodes or thyristors. The input of this stage is three-phase AC signal. The output of this stage is the pulsating DC signal. Let's go slightly deep how this output is generated. Here you can see, for 1/6 of time period, VEAB polarity is such that SCR 1 and 4 are conducting. The direction of current through the resistor is same in every case. For next 1/6 of time period, VEC polarity is such that SCR 1 and 6 are conducting. Similarly, for next 1/6 of time period, VBC polarity is such that SCR 3 and 6 are conducting. The second stage is the rectifier stage. The output of the bridge rectifier is a pulsating DC voltage. To smooth out this pulsation and obtain a relatively constant DC voltage, filter capacitors are used. These capacitors store charge during the peaks of the pulsating voltage and discharge during the gaps, resulting in a more stable DC output. The third and final stage is the inverter stage, which converts DC power into AC power. This stage also consists of six numbers of power switches, mostly IGBTs, arranged in bridge formation. The thyristors are carefully turned on or off by controlling gate pulse using pulse width modulation signal. The PWM signal governs the magnitude of supply voltage and change the frequency of supply. In simple mode, you can see that pair of thyristors are turned on and off, such that the direction of current across the resistor is reverse in each cycle, which resembles AC supply. The same concept is used for converting DC signal into three-phase AC signal. The output of the inverter will be pulsating square wave, which will further smooth out to produce pure AC signal. I hope you understand all about VFD. For more interesting videos, please stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching.